new online Chicago housing assistance portal where residents can find available aid. You'll find a link on our website at WGNTV.com.
The world's largest study on a COVID-19 vaccine has begun, with the first of 30,000 volunteers getting shots. The experimental vaccine was developed by the National Institutes of Health and the drug company Moderna. Participants won't know if they're getting the vaccine or a placebo, but both groups will be closely tracked over the next several weeks. Other vaccines will be tested every month through the fall. Most volunteers will be located in so-called hot spots, where the number of COVID cases are high or rising. A woman from Savannah, Georgia was the first volunteer to take the shot.
It is very exciting. I'm very anxious about it. I just hope that they're really, really good results. I know a lot of people are doing a lot of different vaccine trials and things are going on, but I feel so proud.
Scientists will compare the efficacy and safety of each experimental vaccine. They hope to have a viable vaccine for the general public by the end of the year. And Northwestern Medicine has launched a COVID-19 registry for vaccine trials. Researchers need 5,000 people to sign up for that. Joining us now with more on how the registry would work is Dr. Karen Krueger. She is the principal investigator of the registry. Thank you for joining us. So essentially, you are asking people to sign up in case a trial comes along that might suit them. And I know that these different vaccines work differently. Some are targeted perhaps to older people whose immune system is different.
Right, yeah, so we're trying to recruit interested individuals in the Chicago area to sign up for our registry. So when we have vaccine and other prevention trials available, we have a large pool of individuals to pull from. So we anticipate we'll be starting our first vaccine trial in August.
So I know you're interested in people who are at high risk for potentially getting COVID-19. Who might that be?
We're interested in recruiting individuals who work in high exposure jobs, so such as grocery store workers, factory workers, healthcare workers, individuals who live or work in nursing facilities, nursing homes. We're looking for individuals over age 65, those with certain medical conditions like diabetes or obesity, and then certain racial or ethnic groups that have been disproportionately impacted as well.
Is there anyone who wouldn't qualify, someone you don't want?
So right now, we want to cast a really wide net and get anybody who might be interested in a trial to sign up for the registry, because we don't have all of the protocols yet that we may participate in. So right now, we're just trying to get anybody who's interested. And then when we start with the clinical trials, we'll be able to see how we can match those participants up to a trial that fits for them.
And just to be clear, this is just for vaccines, not for testing any potential medications that might treat COVID-19.
So this is part of a network of trials for prevention of COVID-19. So it right now we're mostly looking at getting vaccine trials up and running, but it's also possible that we could be looking at medications for prevention of COVID-19.
So if they sign up for this year, when it's clear all of the experimental vaccines are being administered, do they potentially get it this year? Do they stay on a list through next year?
So we'll plan on keeping individuals on the list probably for years to come as we start to kind of learn more and develop new trials. But like I said, some of the people who sign up may be eligible for the clinical trials that we're planning on starting as soon as next month. And then if they agree or give us consent to keep their name in the registry, we can continue to look through the registry and contact individuals again if other trials would come up in the future that they would be eligible for.
So I know people potentially get paid for being in the clinical trials. Will they get paid for getting on the list and in the registry, or just once they get into a trial?
So there will be no payment for submitting their information to the registry, and then any sort of payment would depend on the individual trial protocol, which would be described in more detail once the participants would be contacted to see if they'd be interested.
And one last question, because you have the registry of all of the people, will you be following the potential side effects so that's all encapsulated in one place?
So the side effects that we'll be watching for people who actually enroll in the trial will kind of be dictated by that clinical trials protocol. So for example, for the vaccine study that we're planning on starting next month, we'll be following participants for 2 years. But the registry will mostly just be kept, like I said, to have a ready list of individuals to match to trials.